वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड हेल्दी। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी आवर नेक्स्ट एंड वेरी मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉल्यूशन, दैट इज कॉल्ड वाटर पॉल्यूशन। सो आई नो एवरी वन नो अबाउट द वाटर पॉल्यूशन, जस्ट आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग ईच एंड एवरी वर्ड ऑफ द बुक to make you aware about the everything that has been given over you. So first of all, the term water pollution means water, the quality of the water get degraded, means the quality of the water become very bad so that it cannot be more usable further. So how that causes, means how the quality of the water become degraded. So it degraded due to contamination of water bodies, contamination of some unwanted substances into the water bodies, means mixing of some unwanted substances into the water bodies, and how they get mixed due to urbanization, industrialization, and lots of unwanted substance mix into the water bodies and make the water bodies unusable and pollute the quality. Understood? So here the first question comes, define water pollution. Define water pollution. The answer is given over here. Water pollution is the contamination or mixing of water bodies by the discharge of undesirable substance. The substance that should not be mixed into the water, that is called undesirable substance, that are toxic and poisonous. The undesirable substances are generally called water pollutants. So hope you got the answer. So what kind of undesirable substances are mixed into the water bodies? Water pollution occur when pollutants are discharged directly or indirectly into water bodies. Means how does it occur? Either this pollutant directly fall into the water bodies or indirectly comes into the water bodies. So these are the two different ways through which water get polluted. Understood? As a result, the quality of the water deteriorates, means the quality of the water become very bad, which also affect the aquatic ecosystem, means those organisms which live into the water body has badly affected by the water pollution. Okay, so pollution has slipped down the effect of the water, affect the groundwater. Means if the water body get contaminated with the several kinds of chemicals, these water go inside the water table and from which we are using the water. So means suppose this is a tap water from where we get the water for our daily use. So if this water body has get polluted, it obviously pollute that underground water, and this underground water get polluted and which are we using. So it also affect or adversely affect us. Understood? So we will study in very detail each and every steps. Now we are going to understand the different source of water pollution. So note down the question. State the different source of water pollution. State the different. You should make the notes, okay? Different source of pollution. So, from where does the water get polluted? We are going to study each and every step. First of all, domestic sewage. Domestic sewage means the water that is coming from or coming out from your houses, not from your houses, the houses of your neighborhood and the houses which are in the large cities. They emit a lots of, they let off a lots of substances, waste like human scatter, means human latrine, food waste, plastic wrappers, soap, detergent, in the normal garbage generation in the homes. So these are the main substances that are mixed into the water and comes out from the houses in our daily life. And these water, have you ever thought हैव यू एवर थॉट वेयर डज दिस काइंड ऑफ वेस्ट वीड रन ऑफ? ऑब्वियसली वी जनरेट लॉट्स ऑफ वेस्ट इन आवर डेली लाइफ एंड दिस वेस्ट मिक्स इन टू द वॉटर एंड कम्स थ्रू द ड्रेन एंड फ्रॉम स्मॉल ड्रेन इट गोज टू द लार्ज ड्रेन एंड फ्रॉम लार्ज ड्रेन इट गो टू द वॉटर बॉडी एंड इन दिस वे द वॉटर बॉडी गेट पॉल्यूटेड. अंडरस्टूड? सो इट इज द इट इंक्लूड द वेस्ट जनरेटेड इन द ह्यूमन ड्यू टू डे टू डे एक्टिविटी. द वेस्ट सच एज ह्यूमन एक्सेट्रा, फूड वेस्ट, प्लास्टिक रैपर्स, सोप, डिटर्जेंट आर नॉर्मल गार्बेज जनरेटेड इन द होम्स. सम ऑफ द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म प्रेजेंट इन दिस वाटर वेस्ट ब्रीड इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ वाटर एंड कॉज डिप्लीशन ऑफ द ऑक्सीजन. सो इट इज़ वन ऑफ द मेर वेरी बैड इफेक्ट. इन द ह्यूमन स्केट्रा देयर आर लॉट्स ऑफ बैक्टेरिया. नॉट ओनली दैट, द ऑर्गेनिक वेस्ट दैट आर थ्रोन इन द वाटर बॉडी कंटेन ए लॉट्स ऑफ बैक्टेरिया और माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड दिस बैक्टेरिया एंड माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म वेन रीच इन टू द वाटर बॉडीज दे यूज अ लॉट्स ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड deficit the quality of oxygen into the water body due to which the fishes do not get enough oxygen and they dies. So in this way oxygen level depleted by the microorganism. Hope you understood. So that is written over here. Some of the microorganism present in this water body or waste breed in the presence of water, means it goes into the water and start breathing over there and they use a lots of oxygen that is dissolved into the water body. Because you know the animal which live into the water body use the dissolved oxygen. And if that dissolved oxygen is totally used by the microorganism, will they get the enough oxygen for their respiration? Will the fishes get the enough oxygen for their respiration? Obviously not. And that's why it dies due to loss of or due to absence of or due to very less amount of oxygen into the water body. In this way water body get polluted. So it has been written, so it caused the depletion of oxygen resulting in the death and of the aquatic life. So domestic sewage, hope you understand this step. Now we are going to study the another and most important effect of agriculture on the water bodies. You know nowadays for agriculture a lots of insecticide, pesticide, fertilizers, chemical fertilizers are utilizing to improve the farm yield, or you can say improve the yielding of the farmland. So the chemical fertilizers or whatever the it is utilized by the farmers, it run off from the soil to the water bodies due to rain. Means when the rain falls, the rainwater mix with the rainwater mix with the fertilizers, and this rainwater when run off into the water bodies, suppose it is the water body, the what in into the water bodies all the fertilizers comes, and this fertilizer help the algae and small bacteria to grow fast, and these algae and bacteria when grow very fast it totally fill the water body with lots of algae, and this condition is called eutrophication. And due to a large number of algae, the oxygen automatically deplete into the water body and cause the death of the fishes and other water animals or aquatic animals. Hope you understand. So let's study each and every line. Inorganic pesticides and chemical fertilizers are responsible for water pollution. Understood? So how does they move into the water bodies? They move into the water bodies due to rain, because rain washes all the pesticides and chemical fertilizer due to, and they run toward the water body. So these fertilizer are used in increase the crop production. Some fertilizer are acidic in nature and some affect the neutral behavior of the water bodies. Means some make the water body acidic and some are obviously neutral. Due to intensive agriculture cultivation of crops, chemical from fertilizers and pesticide seep into the ground. Means groundwater. Means suppose the farmer are utilizing chemical fertilizers over here into the farmland. When rain comes, the fertilizers mix into the rainwater, and when it sweep into the water table from where we draw the water for our daily use, this water table also get polluted from the fertilizer that are utilized by farmers. Understood? So in this way, the underground water is also get polluted. Routine application of fertilizer and pesticide means daily, or you can say in every agricultural season, if the fertilizers and pesticides are utilized, it increase the nutrient content of the water bodies. Means it which these what these fertilizers move from the ground to the water bodies through rain. So in this way, it leads to the eutrophication. So define eutrophication. I already told you in eutrophication, the quality of water which contain a lots of fertilizer. So what happens if the lots of fertilizer move into the water bodies? It help in the development of lots of algae and bacteria or microorganism, and they grow in very large scale, and obviously due to that it cause the water pollution. So eutrophication, this is the condition when water bodies become rich in nutrient, leading to the massive growth of the unwanted water plants, especially the weeds and algal blooms. And these unwanted plants almost all dissolve oxygen, almost use all the dissolved oxygen. And due to the lack of oxygen, most of the aquatic plants or animals dies. So hope you understood. So define eutrophication and state its effect. State its effect. Hope you got the answer question. Answer of this question. Now, industrial effluent. Industrial effluent means the chemicals or the substances that are emitted from the industries. So industry directly emit whatever the chemicals or the substances that is emitted from the industries are directly emitted into the or let off into the water bodies, and in this way water body get polluted. So wastewater from the industry such as paper, sugar mill, distillers, leather processing systems and pesticide manufacturing unit contribute the water pollution. Means these are the main industry from where lots of chemicals are released every day. So industrial wastewater usually contain harmful chemical compounds such as mercury, lead, copper, cadmium, which are effect of effluent of these industries, can affect the various nervous system and cause the skin infection. Such of the chemicals are dissolved in water body adversely and affect the aquatic life. So what have you come to know from here? From here you come to know about the different thing. I am giving the question, you will understand all the question and also you can write the answer. So name the industries which release a lots of water pollutant. Got? Next question. State the main वाटर पॉल्यूटेंट, वाटर पॉल्यूटेंट रिलीज फ्रॉम द, रिलीज फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्रीज। सो यू गॉट द आंसर ऑफ अनदर क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो। स्टेट द मेन वाटर पॉल्यूटेंट रिलीज फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्रीज। नाउ स्टेट द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ, स्टेट द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ, इम्पैक्ट ऑफ वाटर पॉल्यूटेंट, वाटर पॉल्यूटेंट रिलीज्ड फ्रॉम इंडस्ट्रीज, रिलीज्ड फ्रॉम इंडस्ट्रीज। सो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम कॉज ड्यू टू, अंडरस्टूड? सो दीज आर द थ्री क्वेश्चन दैट हैज बीन गिवन फ्रॉम दिस पैराग्राफ। सो व्हाट आर द इम्पैक्ट, इम्पैक्ट हैज बीन गिवन ओवर हियर। इट कैन अफेक्ट द नर्वस सिस्टम, कॉज स्किन इन्फेक्शन एंड सम ऑफ द केमिकल विच डिजॉल्व इन द वाटर बॉडी एडवर्सली इफेक्ट द वाटर क्वालिटी। सो दीज आर द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल इफुलेंट। अंडरस्टूड? नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अनदर एंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट इज कॉल्ड ऑयल स्पिल। यू नो देयर इज अ लार्ज वाटर बॉडीज लाइक ओशियन एंड सी, एंड अंडर एट द बेड ऑफ द ओशियन एंड सी देयर इज अ लॉट्स ऑफ यू कैन से पेट्रोल और डीजल माइंस। इफ द माइंस गेट रिलीज्ड, ओके, इफ द माइंस गेट लीक्ड, वाट विल हैपन? द पेट्रोलियम और द डीजल विल कम बिकॉज दे आर लाइटर देन द वाटर एंड स्प्रेड ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द वाटर एंड इन दिस वे इट पॉल्यूट द वाटर बॉडीज। इट ऑल्सो कॉज ड्यू टू द लीकेज ऑफ पेट्रोलियम फ्रॉम द शिप और अदर वाटर व्हीकल्स। सो इन दिस वे द क्वालिटी ऑफ द वाटर गेट डिग्रेडेड। सो ऑयल लीकेज फ्रॉम द शिप लीव्स अ सर्टन अमाउंट ऑफ ऑयल इन टू द वाटर विच कॉज वाटर पॉल्यूशन एंड दिस इंडेंजर द लाइफ ऑफ द मैरीन वाटर। मीन्स दोज ऑर्गेनिज्म विच लीव इन टू द मैरीन और यू कैन से ओशियन गेट बैडली इफेक्टेड बाई द ऑयल और पेट्रोलियम। अंडरस्टूड? सो हेयर टू क्वेश्चन कम्स। फर्स्ट डिफाइन ऑयल स्पिल। ऑयल स्पिल, स्पिल मीन्स लीकेज, ऑयल स्पिल एंड स्टेट इट्स इफेक्ट्स, इफेक्ट्स। अंडरस्टूड? सो यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस थिंग्स ऑल्सो। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द थर्मल पॉल्यूशन। सो थर्मल पॉल्यूशन, डू यू नो दैट? थर्मल पॉल्यूशन मीन्स एवरी वाटर बॉडीज हैज अ सम अ फिक्स्ड अमाउंट ऑफ टेम्परेचर इन अ सर्टन क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन। सो व्हाट विल हैपन इफ अ लॉट्स ऑफ हॉट वाटर विल बी थ्रोन और लेट ऑफ इन टू द वाटर बॉडीज? द वाटर गेट सरप्राइजली, और यू कैन सी द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द वाटर इफेक्ट ऑटोमेटिकली चेंज एंड दिस मेक अ शॉक ऑन द लिविंग थिंग्स दैट लिव ऑन दैट वाटर बॉडी। वंस अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस। सपोज देर इज अ फिक्स टेम्परेचर ऑफ द वाटर बॉडीज, सपोज इट इज अबाउट 25 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड टेम्परेचर ऑफ अ वाटर बॉडी एंड सडनली अ इंडस्ट्री रिलीज अ लॉट्स ऑफ हॉट वाटर इन टू दैट वाटर बॉडीज। सपोज दे रिलीज द वाटर एट द बॉइलिंग पॉइंट अबाउट 100 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड एंड दैट वाटर इज डायरेक्टली रिलीज इन टू द वाटर बॉडी। सो वॉट विल हैपन? द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द वाटर बॉडी विच वॉज अर्लियर इज 25 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड ओब्वियसली चेंज एंड इट कम्स अप टू 35 और 40 लाइक दैट एंड दिस इम्पैक्ट बैडली ऑन द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म दैट लिव इन टू दैट वाटर बॉडीज। अंडरस्टूड? वॉट विल हैपन विद देम? दे गेट थर्मल शॉक। मीन्स a large amount of temperature, a large amount of temperature, a large amount of temperature increase, and due to that the living organism gets shock of the thermal, or you can say temperature, and they dies. Understood? So this is called thermal pollution. So let's study each and every line. Power plants and some other factories use the water from the stream or the lakes as a coolant, and the hot water is then returned to the water body, thereby increasing this temperature. This is called thermal pollution. Understood? So once again I am repeating, what power plant, from where do this kind of hot water is released? It is released from the power plant, thermal power plant, and some other factory use water from the stream or lake for as a coolant, means they cool the machine with the help of cold water of the water bodies, and the hot water is then returned back to the water bodies, thereby increase their temperature. This is called thermal pollution, and this also reduce the oxygen content, means when the water bodies get heated, when the water body get heated, the air from the water body is released. Understood? And this will reduce the oxygen content of the water, and this increase the temperature and reduce supply of oxygen, affect aquatic life, cause the death of the plant. For today, that's much. Okay, bye bye.